emphasis that catches the eye, because those statements looked a little ruffling. Let's ask Reema how bad or how discounted all that news is. Reema?
Well, Latha, according to me, it's largely discounted. What Infosys has said is that, you know, in your SEC filing, which you do because it's listed in the United States via the ADR, you have to lay out all the risk factors, pretty much what you do in the case of a DRHP and RHP. And the incremental update in the last 1 year has been the plethora of visa-related issues, whether it stems out from the United States or from Australia or from Brexit. So the company has pretty much laid out the entire scenario with respect to visa. It is not something which is incremental. Even Wipro, I think about 2 weeks ago in its SEC filing, had also laid out very, very similar statements with respect to the visa issue. So this is not something which is incremental or should rattle shareholders. What they've said is something which has played out in the last couple of months. And if it does play out, we all know that there will be a cost implications. One of the, you know, factors that they laid out is that a continuing threat is that some or all restrictions will be applied exclusively to Indian IT companies. But that, again, I think is just the company being cautious and laying out the turf as it is. They're saying that if the legislative proposals are signed into law, then the cost of doing business in the United States may increase dramatically. This could discourage customers from seeking our services, which could adversely impact, materially adversely impact the company's business revenues as well as operating profits. Also, you know, the company, on account of the public spat between the board and the management, they've also said that the board members have been evaluated for the first time via an external agencies, all the 10 board members. Also, this review process was conducted by the search firm Egon Zehnder. And remember, Egon Zehnder was the firm which was used to find Vishal Sikka as a CEO. So they were employed even at that point. The board members answered all the questionnaires. The interviews were conducted as a part of the review. So that is also a couple of the other statements. But that also, I think, you know, is a part of the course. Even Shireen had spoken to Vishal Sikka about how a certain, you know, a committee was being formed. And, you know, to that he had said that, you know what, I'm in the U.S. pretty much most of the time. So it's pretty good that you've got a committee which is looking into, you know, the issues that are there, and the board members being evaluated is also an indication that, you know, of the simmering issues between the, you know, promoters or the founders as well as the management team. But I don't think this is something that you need to read, you know, very adversely. Wipro had said the same thing in its filings 2 weeks ago.
All right. Thank you very much.